Welcome to agricool.com. This video is dedicated for creation of ServiceNow incident through Python and Botcity. Whenever we are working on any incident management system or within a business required to create incident, then probably this automations will help them to minimize their effort of reporting incident on regular basis. Let's consider we have a business process which is demanding to create thousands of incidents on the regular basis. I mean weekly, monthly, yearly. Then probably this automations will help them to minimize their regular activity. In this video, we'll explain you how we can automate incident reporting in ServiceNow with the help of Python and Botcity. This is a very easier and quickest process. Whenever you want to report any issues or incident, assign it to your help desk team for getting resolutions. This creates amazing results for you. Let's consider you are working on your system and you are unable to connect to VPN. It means it is troubling for you to connect within VPN for any of your projects. What you will do, either you can ping the IT support teams through messengers and try to get their availability. Sometimes they are occupied on multiple things and probably you don't have enough time to reach out to them again and again. That's the reason you can always create an incident or create a problem within the ServiceNow and assign it to them straightforward with the help of this automations. It will be just one click and based on that, it will create an incident for you, which is an automatic process where whenever this ticket is assigned to them, it's their responsibility to finish it as quick as possible because in most of the organizations, they are keeping this as a TAT, that is minimum turnaround time for any issues. So if it will go into the process, probably over there, you have to don't worry about it. They will fix it and you will get an update accordingly. Let's understand how we can build this process from scratch. So here, if you can see, I have created one Excel file. Within that, I've added few details like caller ID, category, short description, state, and assignment group. And I've listed three incident or problems, which I wanted to create it with the help of Python and Botcity. This is my Visual Studio code where I will start writing the code so that based on my command, the automations will trigger. Now here we have to install the requirement.txt and based on that we'll get a result. The installation will start. Now after that I will import Botcity Maestro and JSON requests as well as pandas. So these are the library which we are going to utilize it for reporting any incident through JSON or request. Now here to browse the Botcity websites, here we'll add the ServiceNow incident URL. By using that, the bot will navigate directly to the URL and from there we will perform the actions. The dot maximize window, we are going to use it so that our window will be maximized and over there the automations will run smoothly. Now here I will enter username and password, which is a ServiceNow username and password. Even you can also create this username and password in secure node. Either you can access it directly from any buckets or storage bucket, or you can access it through Excel. After that, I have to fill login username. This is the username and password I have to add it. For that, I will inspect the elements and get XPath for both the fields, for username and password, both. Once I will get the XPath, I will add this value to here and from there, we'll add by XPath. Exactly same thing, we'll do it for password as well. To send this key here, login underscore username dot send keys, and we will use username. Exactly similar way, we'll also do it for the password, where I'll add find elements, add the XPath, and then provide the send key details. Now, here, next action is clicking on login button. This is a click actions. That's the reason I will create login underscore button equal to bot dot find elements. And here we'll again try to get the XPath so that the click actions will be performed through bot itself. And post providing the XPath again will call as an event in the functions as quick click, and that's done for the login. Here I'm giving the seconds to perform the login as 10,000. It means 10 seconds. So 10,000 is my milliseconds. So here, when we are providing this, it will become just like a 10 seconds. So we are giving the bot some times to perform this logic, and that's it. Now, post login, we will try to go to the incident page where we have all those incidents are reported. We'll capture the URL and try to integrate it within the code itself, because we want to navigate it to this. So bot.navigate to the locations, I mean the URL, and post that we'll add the detailed URL for the API here. HTTPS and my instance ID. After that, we'll add API now and table. Till this parameter, I wanted to keep this URL ready for me so that we can proceed it further. So now table incident is my URL. After that, I wanted to add headers. So within this headers, because we are using JSON for creating this request, I mean the API request, that's the reason we are going to provide the header as accept application slash JSON's content type will be again exactly same. Now, to read the Excel here, we'll add another logic, because we want those informations to be read. And once the automation will start based on the details which we have in the Excel file, the incidents will be created. Now here I provided Excel file, data.xls is my file name, and pd.readExcel file. So this is how we can read the Excel stored somewhere so that we can utilize it for creating columns. So creating a new column for incident number, here we'll add definitions, and that is incident number, and that's a incident number, which is first field none, because incident number is automatically generated. That's the reason we are just providing none. We want the automatically generated ID. We want to iterate the complete process in loop. That's the reason I've here for index row in definitions the f dot iterate rows payload. We'll use it here, and based on that, the automations will run. Here we are going to provide each and every ID. First is caller ID, because we need that caller ID to be added. And if you can see here, whenever I'm clicking on new tab, this will open a new window for me where we will get a complete form. And based on the form, we are adding different details. So here we'll inspect each and every fields to add the XPath, and based on that, the value will be fed through bot itself. So I'm generating XPath for caller ID. Either we can use the XPath, or with the ID, we can identify the locations, and based on that, the value will be fed. Next is category, and post that we'll start using it for the state. So inspect element is giving us the name of the fields. Whatever field names we have, that field name has to be matched exactly, otherwise we'll get an error. Now three fields are done. Next we'll start with the short descriptions, because we wanted to identify the short descriptions as well. So whichever fields with available in my Excel file, I have to target each and every field, provide the mapping, and then we can continue further. So assignment group is again left after this, which will be also use it. Now next is assignment group, and here we'll again provide the mapping for assignment groups, and within the row we'll use the same path. Now because we wanted to create incident, so here we'll use post request, and based on that our incidents will be created successfully. So in this process you can see I have used response request.post URL. Because we have added the URL, it will fetch those authentication, which is username and password, headers, and within the headers, because we have provided details, and after that we'll use data. So this is json.dumps and the payload, because we have provided the payload mapping there. Next, I wanted to check the status code. Whenever the incidents will be created, I need 201. And if 201 is available, we will capture the response. So if result in response data is incident number, we'll try to get this incident number and paste into the Excel file itself. So which will be our final result. So whenever the automations run, it will create an incident number, and this incident number will be either shared with the users. Returning back to the same examples which we have started, let's consider I am the user. I wanted some resolutions from the helpdesk team. I have created one request through bot, but I need the incident number for my proof, right? So these incident number will be captured, and here I'm printing it. Post that, we'll add it even into the Excel file as well, or we can share through email. Totally depending on your requirement, how you wanted to add it. Now here, diff.add index incident number and incident number will be added successfully, else I wanted to print unexpected response structure for row and then providing the index itself. And for another if, I'm providing field to get incident details, that is the else conditions, or sorry, else message. Now exactly same incident number, I wanted to add it into the Excel file here. So we, at the end of the execution, we should have some data available. I mean the incident number available for each of the requests. We'll run this complete process through here, and post that we will also trigger it orchestrator so that we can have at least some response. So whenever the automations will run, it will run the browser and maximize the window, and post that it will enter the URL where I wanted to perform the login. Bot will itself enter username and password, try to go to the link or URL which we have provided for creating an incident. Because we have here, we have given 10 seconds of delay, that's reasons it's waiting page to load, and then the navigate actions will be performed. After creating the incident, it will try to get the details. You can see we have just logged 3 incidents, and you can also see the timing as well, the right side. And these are the incident ID which is printed here. So these are the incident ID which is printed here. And the incident ID is also added within the Excel itself so that we can share with any user who has requested to create this incident through bot. So this is the complete process which we have built it or executed it through Python and Botcity. Let me show you the complete execution through orchestrator. Now here, once I will deploy and execute the process, it will start executing the process quickly. It will not take much time. Exactly same process has been done through Botcity as well. So either we can schedule it, or we can directly trigger the process itself immediately. And whenever the execution will start, we will have the final results available. And these final results will be listed in our Excel sheet where we have the incident ID generated. Now you can see the automation started. It will go to the ServiceNow page, try entering the credentials, and navigate it to the incident page where we can report the incident. And after that, it will create incident quickly. And once the incident is available, you can see this is just now it's created. So you can also compare with the time frame, how much time it took. It's very quicker where we can report any ServiceNow incident through Botcity orchestrator, which is again very quick. Post the process is completed, we'll have the incident available into the Excel file, and you can see the process is finished now. So that's how we can create incident directly from the Botcity using Python. That's all about this video. Hope you enjoyed the content. If you think so this will be useful, don't forget to share within your circle. And if you wanted to learn more concepts related to the Botcity and Python, feel free to add your topic name in the comment sections based on the demand. I will be happy to create more content related to that. Till then, happy learning.